in the US. C is from Korea, but C is in internship, knowing about NGO's life. But we can ask her about her point of view about migrant in Singapore, because C is also have a lot of migrant friends here, even C just a short time in Singapore. So I will introduce her to you.
Hello! Hi, Jen. So how are you?
I'm good, thank you so much. How about you?
I'm really good.
Nice. Yeah. So, during... can you tell us what you do here in Singapore and why you do that?
Yeah, so I'm interning at home. So, humanitarian organization for migration economics. So, my job description is the research work for the foreign workers, especially foreign caregivers working conditions.
Yeah. So, like, during your time here in Singapore, how you think about the migrant in Singapore? Because you're interested in the humanitarian about migrant, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is the first time to see their life, the migrants' life in the Asia. So it's really huge, and then when I see it first time, it's really good and well organized. But as far as I know, there's also some people struggle with in some situations where between some employers or I can see that some good side also, and I see that some bad side as well. So yeah, it's really big culture in Singapore. Yeah, so.
Right. Yeah, like you can see every country's people in Singapore, like
so
you can see the world in Singapore.
Yeah, definitely. You know, I saw the Indonesian people, and then the Filipino,
yeah.
Even European people also,
yep.
They are working here as a foreigner.
Yeah, right.
So yeah, I see a lot of the Asian people here.
Okay. So like in your internship here, how you think and what you can see that is there anything can be better for migrants?
Actually I studied more about the policy side of the foreign caregivers, because I heard that Singapore is a really big place, a really important place to go to the Canada or more good working conditions country,
right?
So many people learn some caregivers skills in here,
mm-hmm.
And then they said some migrants said, migrant workers said, if you have some experience working in Singapore, they have a more chance to get some visa from some Canada or any other country. So that's what I many Asians in the neighbor country coming here and then more learning some skills here, and then there's a lot of the good research to learn some of the kind of skills. Yeah, so I'm quite interested about that. Yeah.
So like you are also a migrant, right? In the US.
Yeah.
So do you have any tips for all migrant friends over there? Like how do you deal with all the struggle? Maybe I can say all the migrants have the same issue. Not like I know it's different, but they always have something similar.
Right.
Do you have any tips for them?
A really good question. So I feel like first of all, basically we have not much understand about the foreign countries' culture and the languages, and then we also can speak in English, or we can
a little bit understand about the culture things, and then it's not that much bothering what you have to do
in the workplace, but sometimes in the, some vulnerable situations, the limited language and the limited understanding of the culture is really difficult to communicate with other people and then protect yourself.
True.
So I feel like government or NGO also still continue to equip some skills about the community. Not just the basic languages, but just the communicate skills.
Like about migrant rights
migrant rights.
To make their life like better, to
migrant rights,
express
how to negotiate your wage, how to communicate with your boss or something.
True.
So, and then more cultural thing as well. Mm-hmm. So, and then I feel like this is not just needed at the first time. I think continuously taking care of the foreign workers or the continuing concern is really important to better understand each other or the working make making a real a good working conditions.
That's very honestly, it's very good work from you. I mean, basically all the migrants have to have understanding about the country they're working at and about the language, and don't stop improving yourself and keep learning and fill yourself with skills so that you can have a chance to have a better life, right?
Yeah, definitely.
So thank you so much, Jennifer. Very nice to talk with you, and we wish you have a good life in the future.
Yeah, you too.
And
hope you really have a really good experience, and then
thank you.
Influence to the other migrant workers as well.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, guys, for seeing this video, and I hope you get some inspiration from this, and I hope you can spread this video and continue supporting us. See you in the next video. Thank you. Bye. Bye, Jennifer.
Bye.